Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Najwa Hussaini with Azadi News. Burmese military arrests three Rakhine women for alleged ties to Arakan army. Burma may postpone election in war-torn Arakan, state said official. Police in Arakan State's Jokpia Township have opened cases against three Rakhine women under the counter-terrorism law for allegedly funding the ethnic rebel group Arakan Army AA. According to a statement on Tuesday from the Burmese military's True News Information Team, Burmese military troops arrested alleged AA supporter Oo Nini Tu, a resident of Yenin Tu village, on July 18. After the military troops interrogated him, they then arrested three women from the same village on July 22. In its statement on Tuesday, the military claimed that troops seized a camouflage uniform without a badge and two police uniforms with insignias and badges from the house of one of the women, Da Kim Ma Shui. The military has accused her of soliciting support for the AA in the township. The military accused two other women, Da La Thanky and Da Pei Mei, of collecting protection money and food for the AA from local residents. The three women face charges under Section 50J of the counter-terrorism law, which prohibits financing terrorism, as well as Section 52A, which prohibits activities that knowingly involve a terrorist group. They face up to 7 years in prison if convicted. Myanmar military troops summoned them and took them immediately without talking to anyone else or looking for any evidence, said Rakhine State lawmaker U Cha Lue of Chakpyu Township. As far as I know, there is no evidence that the three women supported the AA. That they made arrest based on the account of one individual reflects that the rule of law is quite poor. The lawmaker described the three women as pillars of the community in their village and said he believes they are wrongly accused. The Myanmar military has filed lawsuits against dozens of local residents in northern Arakan on suspicions that they have ties to the AA. Burma will postpone elections in parts of war-torn Arakan state if the military declares them unsafe, a senior election official said on Thursday, prompting a backlash from ethnic parties with strong support in the region. It is necessary to have peace and stability to hold elections, said Union Election Commission Chair Latte, adding that the army-controlled ministries of defense and home affairs would soon determine whether the region was stable. If they cannot give the recommendation, we will not do it, he told Reuters in an interview in the capital, Naypyidaw. Military spokesmen did not answer phone calls seeking comment. The nation goes to the polls on November 8 in what analysts see as an important test of the transition away from direct military rule, but preparations have been complicated by the coronavirus pandemic and escalating ethnic conflict. Longtime opposition leader Aung San Suu Kyi's National League for Democracy Party took power in 2016 after a landslide election win that ended half a century of army rule, though the military retained significant powers. While Aung San Suu Kyi remains wildly popular among the country's majority Burmese Buddhist population, analysts say support for her party has waned among minority communities. This is today's news. To get more updates about Rohingya, subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell. Visit our website azadinews.org and follow our social media accounts. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.